God bless you. God bless you.
I'm not here today as a comedian. I'm here as a citizen of the country in Lagos State.
Who has the interest of the people in mind?
My wife at the moment is being threatened by SARS. Yes. I fear that if I drive now and I go home, I could get a bullet in my head. It could be my sister.
It could be,
my brother. Be any of us.
It could be my loved one.
True.
Sir, I want to say something now. Not even you now. You, let me not go to the governor, the deputy governor, or the speaker yet. If you, sir, sent for me, given the circumstance, not for this, before all of this happened, if you sent for me, call that day boy, that call that Mr. Macaroni, I want to see him. It's not possible that I will say, manager, lover me, reach for staff.
Now, Mr. Dayo, he didn't call you.
Commissioner, any. So they mean tawa mbi. If we say we want to see the one that we elected into office, we want to see not too much. It's not too much. This that is happening, it happens once in a while.
Yes.
I was here, I said it this afternoon, I'm still saying they can bully me. I was here doing xenophobia attack. We marched from ICM, we marched, later we came here, we finished here.
Make it talk, let that talk now.
Please, I allowed you to take the lead. Please let me take it.
Vibrate.
We are here this afternoon. We spoke with the deputy speaker. We told him that we are here to stay. Please, did the deputy speaker agree or not?
Yeah.
God bless you. We were here this evening. The chief of staff, Mr. Taya, they came here and he spoke to us.
Yes.
And we respectfully asked him that we are allowed to stay in this place. He told us we are welcome.
Is the safest place in Lagos State to stay?
In
courts!
In courts! In courts! In courts! However, 20 minutes later, we saw the CP, we got pointed at us. Unarmed citizens of Nigeria.
Yes. Like
they pointed guns at us. They did not engage us. They did not ask us anything. They did not tell us anything. And they went, took off the tents, took off the socks, switched off everything, and told us to take away our cars or else it will be towed away. They even came with towing vehicles. They pointed guns at us, took away the chairs, and made us sit on the floor like criminals. Okay. We are not criminals. We want to know. I want
why?
Answers to that.
Yes.
I have apologized.
We do not want an apology, sir.
Well, that is just out of respect. I have apologized.
Thank you.
I wasn't here when the tents
or
the items were taken
away.
But let me say this. I think the most important is to resolve our standing here.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, I cannot.
Yeah, you're welcome to this YouTube channel. As usual, you know this is number one stop for entertainment news, gist, information. Just name it. We got you covered on anything you guys want. Yes. So today it's gonna be about the EndSARS protest also. You know, we've been giving you updates about the EndSARS protest and the Nigerian celebrities who have, you know, led Nigerian youths toward, you know, the cause of putting an end to SARS mutiny and brutality. So now the popular Nigerian skit maker Debo Adedayo, popularly known as Mr. Macaroni, he is a popular skit maker on Instagram and here on YouTube. This guy has, you know, lent his voice on the end SARS protest, and well, he has given a very sound support to Nigerian youth and a very big voice to the Nigerian youth on the EndSARS protest. Well, Mr. Macaroni, as we all know him, he's so popular on the social media. We know him to be this funny guy, but this time around I believe Mr. Macaroni is not here to make comedy videos, and he is actually not here to, you know, joke with the government of Nigeria. According to Mr. Macaroni, he said, we elected these politicians, they just to work for us, and they should not, you know, turn deaf ears to us whenever they are working for us. That they should address our grievances as Nigerians. They should address it with immediate alacrity. Mr. Macaroni, alongside some popular celebrities, the likes of Fowles, the likes of Sydney Talker, the likes of Runtown. Well, this protest was spearheaded by Runtown and Fowles, a bad guy. On Sunday, Runtown posted on his social media handle, his Twitter handle, that he will be leading a protest on Thursday, 8th of October, year 2020, and he was supported by Fowles, the bad guy. And yesterday, 8th of October, year 2020, they took to the street all the way from Lekki on the island to the governor's office in Ikeja, Alausa Ikeja, just to protest and address the issue of SARS. Well, Mr. Macaroni, on the other hand, took this far by not leaving the governor's office. He never left the governor's office gate. He was, you know, agitating for the end SARS protest. And, well, he believed that with this, he would, you know, spearhead a kind of revolution. Well, I believe a revolution is about to come through from Nigerian youths. Well, a kind of revolution on the end SARS. Well, they believe enough is enough. Nigerians, they want a kind of change that will be drastic. They want it to be obvious that the government are working towards ending SARS and banning SARS brutality in Nigeria. Mr. Macaroni took it so far that he had to sleep at the governor's office gate. Yeah, he had to sleep at the governor's office gate and demanding to see the Speaker of the House of Assembly, the Lagos State House of Assembly. Well, this is quite laudable on the side of Mr. Macaroni, as the Nigerian youth on social media lauded Mr. Macaroni for this. They, you know, gave him a very sound round of applause for giving a voice to the Nigerian youth and, you know, agitating and protesting for the banning of SARS, to for the government of Nigeria to end SARS. And on the other hand, the protest also continues today, Friday, 9th of October, year 2020. Nigerian youths, they said they are not stopping, they are not, you know, trying, they are not relenting, no retreat, no surrender. They are, you know, pushing forward, they are agitating towards the ending and banning of the federal SARS, the special anti-robbery squad in Nigeria. Well, on the placards of the Nigerian youth, we could see boldly written that wearing nice outfits doesn't mean you are a criminal. Using an iPhone doesn't mean you are a criminal. Having a laptop doesn't mean you are a criminal. Meanwhile, they believe that the SARS, they've, you know, gone beyond their jurisdiction. The jurisdiction of SARS, as stated by the Constitution of Nigeria, is to apprehend, you know, apprehend armed robbers. Their basic duty is to apprehend armed robbers, wage in doing robbery and all. But the SARS have gone beyond the boundaries. They've gone beyond their jurisdiction of duties, and they started, you know, harassing Nigerian youths. They've been, you know, like I said, harassing Nigerian youths, extorting Nigerian youths, all in the name that these innocent Nigerian youths are embarking on financial crimes, which is actually the job of the EFCC, Economic and Financial Crime Commission of Nigeria. But the SARS have taken it upon themselves to, you know, apprehend Nigerians. But this time around, Nigerian youths are not taking it easy on SARS. They are working towards banning SARS. And, well, the PRO of the Nigerian Police Force, Mr. Frank Mba, has spoken, and he has said that the Nigerian youths are actually clout chasing. He regarded Nigerian youths as clout chasers. He said that Nigerian youths are, you know, just, you know, making noise. But he said they cannot ban SARS. Instead, they would reform SARS. But Nigerian youths never wanted that. Now, let's take a clue into Mr. Macaroni's lifestyle and all. So, Mr. Macaroni graduated from the Redeemers University. He graduated from the Redeemers University, like I said. He was a one-time president of the union of the Redeemers University. He sued the Redeemers University at a time when he was supposed to graduate, but he was rusticated after his final year exam. Yes, he was rusticated for a post he made on Facebook calling out the management of the university. But Mr. Macaroni, at the court premises, he won this case against the university. Well, Mr. Macaroni could be said to be a long-standing agitator, a long-standing activist. Well, let's see what unfolds of the end SARS of a protest as Nigerians continue this protest. Naira Marley, on the other hand, has, you know, gone on a live video with the PRO of the Nigerian Police Force, Mr. Frank Mba, and, well, Mr. Frank Mba told him boldly that the SARS will be reformed. And Naira Marley gave the PRO and the Nigerian Police Force entirely an ultimatum of 7 days to work on this. An ultimatum of 7 days to work on this. And if nothing is done on this, well, Naira Marley and his Malian people will take to the streets to protest massively against SARS. Well, let's see as things unfold. Probably things would work out the way we expect. Keep subscribing to this channel, guys. Thank you very much. We love you very much.